Hi! If you ever tried your hands in photogrammetry, you might have realized some objects are easier to scan than others. A dull surface with lots of color detail make it easy to scan, but other objects may prove way more tricky. For example, these glasses. They're transparent to large extents, the surface is pretty shiny, not so much color, and then you got really thin pieces as well. I'm Peter from Xoio. Let me show you how we achieved fairly good results. So we did a couple of trial and errors. I'm going to show you this one. For our scan, we were not interested in the transparency or the color of our object. In this attempt, we tried to cover our object with colorful stickers, and like this give the software enough contrast and detail to work with. The first point clouds looked actually quite promising, but the generated mesh was full of holes and not enough to work with. So the secret ingredient that finally made it work was chalk spray. And here goes a quick shout out to my colleague William for bringing up that idea. An important little disclaimer at this point. Use a test object to see if the chalk spray really works for you. Do enough test runs and see if the chalk spray comes off nicely. Especially scratched surfaces might be hard to clean. And please don't hold me responsible if you ruin your original one way or the other. That being out of the way, let's start spraying my glasses. Start using the chalk spray like any other spray. Try to keep the cover as thin as possible and let it dry quickly. Alright, that's looking good enough. Give it some time to dry completely. Handle your object quite cautiously because the paint comes off quickly, which is a good thing. It's probably good to double check if you got all areas covered before proceeding to the next step. Obviously, we removed all translucent and transparent areas and furthermore got rid of all highlights. But this is most probably not enough for good photogrammetry results. In my experience, it really helps to create a lot of contrasty, colorful areas that your software can work with. We looked around what possibly could achieve this. I decided to use an old toothbrush and some toothpaste to sprinkle the surface. Giving it some time to dry, we already had some detail. Now I used some black fineliner to create some additional black detail, turning my glasses into some kind of Keith Haring art object. I paid attention not to use anything that would contain aggressive solvents that could damage the surface underneath. And last but not least, I made use of some of the stickers that you saw in the previous attempt. Let's proceed to the shooting. Try setting up an evenly lit environment using soft lights and area lights, because they will avoid generating highlights on your object as much as possible. I personally prefer to place my objects on some colorful backdrop. Classic newspapers might be ideal because they're not glossy at all. So why am I doing this? Well, in my experience, these backdrops tremendously help with the camera alignment, especially with difficult objects like this one. Surely they are part of the point cloud being generated, but depending on the software you're using, you should be able to crop off these areas in the later part of the generation process. One thing that's not ideal in my process here is the shallow depth of field. Try to avoid noise and overbright areas. Try to retain as much sharpness as possible throughout the whole image. When you're all set up, shoot your object from as many angles as possible. Be generous here and don't save on the amount of photos you're taking. 40 to 60 shots is totally fine. Alright, let's look at the process results in agisoft. Seems like all the cameras are properly aligned. You can see that the point cloud extends far beyond the object, but we can crop this in agisoft in the next step. Here we can see the dense point cloud being generated out of these cameras. The scene has already been cropped to an area of interest. It looks like we're gonna have some holes, especially in the temples of the glasses, but I'm fine with that because I can easily interpolate this in my 3D software. In the next step, agisoft generates a mesh out of this point cloud. Now it might be that you find huge gaps and holes in your 3D scan, which also happened to me in this project. I went back to my original object, my glasses, and created some more diffuse detail, especially in areas that were difficult for the scan, and redid the photoshoot. If you're finally happy with your 3D scan, now comes the exciting part. Let's see how the chalk spray comes off. As you can see, I rinsed my glasses under running warm water, and then with clean fingers I tried to scrub off the chalk spray. Using some non-aggressive detergent also helps to get into all these creases. And finally, using a very, very soft toothbrush, I managed to get the chalk out of all the little gaps. So that's my source object after 2 to 3 minutes of cleaning. Finally, I imported my model into Blender, the software I wanted to use for the retopology process. I also make use of the texture to see all the fine details. What you see on the screen has already been cleaned from all the leftover bits from the 3D scan. I start my retopo process by dragging a couple of edges across my source object. And here it is, my final model. I didn't do any details on the hinges yet, but the curvature of the glasses should follow close enough to the original object. Alright, this was the whole process. Please let me know in the comments if this was useful for you. See you in the next tutorial. Bye bye!